Good morning. Thursday morning. I love Thursdays. Heading now to meet my boy Asaf at Apester. You met them a couple of weeks ago. This is a follow-up meeting. After that, I'm going to meet the SAP team, yet another follow-up meeting, and then lunch with my boy Rob from Neo, a super cool platform for digital art. After that, I have a call this afternoon with Zedge, a very, very successful app. That's a long story, and there's going to be hopefully some big news coming on that front as well. And then tonight, we have Shlomo Mervis' kids bar mitzvah, the CEO of Intelligo. So all in all, it's going to be a fantastic day and fantastic way to end the week. Let's do this. Bright and early meeting with Asaf Gilad from Apester. The guy used to be one of the top journalists in Israel. Went over to the dark side, or the bright side, to become a marketer at a super duper hot company. I have no idea where the office is, though. Thought it was this building. Apparently, I was wrong. There is something super cool about a company that is building an empire that almost no one has ever heard of. Apester is like a beast of a company. They work with all the top tier tech publications, not just tech publications, all the top tier online publications. Have you heard of Apester? Most people haven't. It's incredible. Super cool company. Now running to SAP. Made it to the new Azrieli Sarona Tower, and I am genuinely convinced that whoever designed this parking lot was on drugs. To find the elevator was like, I'm still not sure I even found it. Oh, here are the elevators. Super confusing. Sometimes things get to my head and I get a little, someone just lost their phone. So this nice woman just came over to me and said to me, you know, I'm just gonna tell you something. I realize that like, I know I have X amount of followers on the internet, but it's very hard. You don't put a face to the number, right?
Right.
So when someone comes over and says, I follow you, I read your stuff. It's like,
I'm the face to
really?
The number.
Wait, so who are you? What's your story?
Hi, my name is Inbar. I'm Israeli, and I have family in the States.
Wait, how come you sound so American?
I lived abroad as a kid, went to a private school.
What are the chances that you come over, your name is Inbar, I'm going to meet an Inbar right now?
Not random, very
right?
High.
What do you do?
I'm an intern for the next 10 days at a law firm called Pearl Cohen.
Oh, sweet. Beautiful. Where are you from? Where's your family live in the States?
Florida, New Jersey.
Where in New Jersey?
Classic Jews. I don't know.
T-Rex.
But so they were here. I have to run. My cab is outside. But they were here.
Okay.
And my friend told me, listen, there's this guy in the tech in Israel. You have to follow him.
Wow.
And I was like, okay.
Where are you based?
I'm right here. I'm on the 52nd.
Where do you follow
floor?
Me? On what platform?
Facebook.
Send me a message. We're having coffee.
Okay, let's do it.
Great to meet you. Thanks for coming over. What's your name?
Gabby.
Is that bird? Is that the new bird? Who makes the scooter?
So.
Oh, it's a Xiaomi, you think? They just opened their store here.
2 months ago, yeah.
Yeah, wait, what's your name?
Gabriella.
Are you American?
I'm American.
From?
From New York.
From where in New York?
Rockland.
I'm from Queens.
You're from Queens?
You live here now?
I live here now.
What do you do?
I work here.
What do you do?
I work at SimilarWeb.
Get out of here. Or is
yeah.
My boy.
Really?
Yeah, so is Jason.
Yeah.
What do you do there?
I'm a market intelligence representative.
Do you work with Aaron Friedman?
Yes.
Wait, what's your name again? Remind me. I told
Gabby.
You. Gabby what?
Kaplan.
Fantastic to meet you.
You too.
Glad you said hello. Let's have coffee sometime.
Right,
go look yourself up on YouTube.
Bye.
Take care. Enjoy the scooter. How long ago? It was like last week, was it, when we met the first
three
time?
3 weeks ago.
Was it 3 weeks ago? Wow. I thought it was like last week. I have no clue. Anyway, so 3 weeks ago, apparently, I was in SAP Labs, and I sat with Noah, who's ex-Microsoft and who's sort of a rock star. But behind every successful woman, there's another successful woman. So she was sitting behind the camera, and you didn't get to meet her, but let's start with, who are you, first of all?
So, hi. I'm Inbar Jacobi, the Ecosystem Relations Manager at SAP Labs.
Fantastic title. I'm jealous of your title. Okay, so first of all, give me your background. What did you do before SAP?
So I think it's 4 years that I'm working with startups, MNCs, VCs. My first role is investors relations.
Cool.
At Habanana. It's a really cute hub.
Habanana?
Habanana.
How did I not hear about this place?
Yeah, it's in Ra'anana.
Interesting.
It's a house for entrepreneurs.
Sweet. Cool. You did investor relations, you said?
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Okay, and then after that?
After that, I managed the IEC. It's the IDC Entrepreneurship Club.
Love it. Awesome. Then 6 months ago, you joined SAP, your dream job.
Yep.
You're having the greatest time. Sounds like you're having the greatest time. Give me, as we say in Hebrew, on one leg, give me the high-level overview of things, all the things that you have your hands in and the things that you're doing, all the different kind of components of SAP, because SAP, as we said last time, is an absolute beast of a company, like one of the biggest out there. So just give me, like, dumb it down for me a little bit. What do you do?
So first, we have the R&D center in Ranana, where SAP is building the cloud.
Coolest building ever.
Yeah, the cloud platform.
Okay.
So there I'm doing the ecosystem relations, hosting meetups, other tech ecosystems, taking the developers out. Like, we have the brightest minds in the lab, and I want to give their knowledge to the ecosystem. So
awesome.
Speakers and yeah.
Super cool. Okay, that's one thing.
That's one.
Yeah.
And then we have SAP.io Fund. It's a CVC located in Tel Aviv. Investing in early stage startups, SaaS B2B.
Got it. So that's a fund.
It's a fund.
A VC fund that SAP deploys capital and invests in startups that have synergy with SAP.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, they're not going to invest in something that's not relevant at all. And that's relatively small but strategic checks. In other words, the amount of money that they're investing isn't the big deal. The big deal is that now SAP gets behind you and can push this company to incredible things. Okay, so that's the second thing. Yeah, what else?
And then we have the Foundry. The Foundry, SAP has five foundries around the world, and one of them is The Junction.
Cool.
We're partners at The Junction, one of the leading accelerators in Israel, and the oldest one.
Nice.
So
is it really? Personal?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
One of the oldest.
Cool.
Yeah.
So I've been mentoring there, I think, since day one, I'm pretty sure. Very, very good accelerator, but I haven't been there in a while. I should go back.
Yeah, you should.
Okay. So, so you guys are doing a lot of things, and your role in these things is, like, ecosystem facing?
Yeah. And,
super
and
cool.
To synchronize all these entities, and
okay. So, if a startup's watching, what would you say is your, let's not call to action, but what is the value if an entrepreneur is watching that SAP that you can help them with? What would you say, you know, they should reach out to SAP to collaborate on, or to, what's the main kind of added value?
So we have like four forms that we can give value to.
Okay.
So we have the brightest minds in Ranana that can do like CTO office hours and mentorship.
Really?
They're amazing.
I didn't even know. Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah.
Okay. How do people find out more about that?
Okay, they need to reach me.
Okay, so all the things that you're able to say now, the best is to reach out to you.
Yeah.
Okay, so you'll tell your email afterwards. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Go on. All right.
Early stage startups that are looking for investment. So this is the SAP.io fund. People that are looking for acceleration program, that's The Junction. Or the four other accelerators around the world. We have in Paris, we have in Berlin, we have in San Francisco, and we have in New York.
Sounds like you have everything a startup needs.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so if the startup's watching this, and they want to reach out to Inbar Yaakovi, what's the best way to do that?
My email, my cell phone, my mobile.
You don't want people calling you. What's your email?
Yeah, my email. So it's inbar.yaakovi.
inbar.yaacoby. Y at the end?
At sap.com.
Simple, beautiful. Joseph, put her email right there. And if you guys, entrepreneurs, startups, VCs, investors, ecosystem players, you think there's any synergy with SAP, reach out to Inbar. Super cool. Glad I didn't have to, you know, I was playing it like cool. Like, I was like, you want to do an interview? If you would have said no, I would have forced you anyway, but just kidding. You know, I'm glad we got to do this. And listen, amazing stuff. Obviously, anything you do to help, our goals are completely aligned. You want to do what I want to do, which is help this ecosystem. So it's super cool. And we're going to continue the dialogue, continue the conversation. I have a feeling for a long time. You also have amazing people in the organization, like Noah, like David Lang, who's the best. Many other people, so you know, I'm very happy. I don't even remember how we, I think it was just like a friendly meeting with Noah, but it's just, I'm happy we did connect because there's gonna be a lot of good stuff happening, and just keep kicking butt. So good luck with everything, and let me know how I can help.
To be continued.
There you go, boom. The thing about Israeli tech is you walk around the streets and you bump into legends. Bump into legends. Legending. Oh, nice. Well played. It was very well played. Who are you?
I'm Oded. I'm a good friend of yours.
It's true. Beyond that, what? Give me your background in 2 seconds. We're like standing here in 95 degree weather.
So I'm an entrepreneur. I'm a chief marketing officer. I'm a product manager. And currently, I'm a GDPR consultant for tech companies in Israel.
You forgot to mention one thing. You're a lawyer.
I'm also a lawyer.
No one's perfect.
Yeah.
Awesome.
No one admits it unless they have to.
So you
especially
were,
if they're in tech,
you were CMO right? of Mindspace before, right?
I was.
One of the hottest co-working spaces here in Tel Aviv. Now you're working with startups in the GDPR thing. Well, good luck. We have to have steak soon, and it's good. I'm glad we got a chance to bump into each other. At least that.
Let's
but
do
we're
that.
Gonna do steak soon.
Let's do that.
Hello, dude. Thanks, man. Talk to you soon. Good-looking guy sitting on my left. You should see his wife.
Do you know something?
Am I allowed to make jokes like that?
Every time we have these conversations, we go down the same route, don't we? You're much more interested in her than me, but it's okay. So
I mean, let's just get it out of the way. Okay, his wife's a supermodel, one of the top supermodels in Israel. It's a true story. I'm not making this stuff up.
But, it is a true story.
But these guys are him and his wife are close friends of ours. Love this guy. Been following his career and his new venture since the beginning.
Yeah.
All right. Who are you? What's your name? And what do you do?
Okay. The name is Rob Anders.
That's a very what's it called of you? The name is Bond.
It's just the British accent,
know,
it works
right?
well. So,
yes.
I am the co-founder and CEO of a company called Neo, N-I-I-O, Neo.art. And we are a platform for digital art. And essentially what we're doing is aggregating the biggest collection of the world's highest, most premium quality digital artworks, moving image artworks, which you experience on screens across the places where we're living, working, and our public spaces. So we're turning our walls into digital canvases, basically.
Dude, you are like a pitching machine.
Listen, I learned from the best.
Fist bump. It was amazing. All right, so listen, let's break this down here. Art. Like high-end art, like you go to a gallery, you see art. That world, which is well beyond my scope, is a massive, massive market. Could you give me some numbers so I understand how big that let's call that part of the market? How big is it?
So if we're doing the high-end art market for purchases, it's close to $70 billion a year.
Okay.
But what's pretty crazy is that there is no ceiling on price. And what's more crazy than that, or more exciting for that, is the fact that there's a big trend for art going out of the galleries and museums into all of the environments where we are. And what's important to know is artists will always use anything they can access to create their artwork and tell their story. Okay. And you will know better than I do, given that you're always here with your mobile phone and everything else.
Several of them, actually.
So, artists are using now digital tools.
Right.
So whether this is photography, video, augmented reality, virtual reality, all of these rich formats that, the high-tech scene here is talking about. But we're working with artists who are creating their artworks using these tools, so virtual reality artworks, interactive video artworks, and then we're experiencing them across our walls.
Wherever you're sitting right now watching this, look around you. Look around the room you're sitting in right now. How many screens do you see?
How many walls do you see?
How many walls do you see? These guys are capitalizing on that, and they're bringing high-end digital art to the screens in our lives, whether it's in a hotel, in a boardroom, in your house, anywhere that there's a wall and a screen or potential for a screen, it will now be populated by Neo Art. Unbelievable. But let's take a step back here for one second, or step forward. Give me some names, whatever you're allowed to talk about publicly, of companies you are partnering with.
So,
or cities or anything.
So in some of the screen companies, we're working with people like Philips and Samsung, who are integrating us inside their screens, all different types of screen technologies. And then with customers, we're going with people like Marriott, for example, who are putting Neo's digital art into hundreds of their hotels in the lobbies. We're working with some of the shared workspaces, people who are looking to actually change the way in which we experience interior spaces. And I think this is the key thing. People talk about being in a subscription economy. We believe that we're living in an experience economy, and we're making decisions by how we experience often our environment. So in an office, we want our employees to feel that this is a cool place to be working and experiencing. In hospitality environment, they're differentiating through experience, and we're doing this by giving people the chance to access the world's finest, top quality digital format artworks, which was previously inaccessible.
Incredible.
Very cool.
All right, let's talk for 2 seconds, and I know you gotta go.
By the way, Thursday nights at the Norman Hotel in Tel Aviv, we're there every week at the moment. Come and experience art being displayed, projected onto the walls, on screens in the bars.
How close are you with the Norman Hotel?
We're very close.
Can you tell them to take care of the kosher food situation, please? Anyway, moving along now.
Okay.
It's like awkward.
Yaron, if you hear and see this, you heard what he said.
Let's talk for 2 seconds. I know you got to go, but 2 seconds. Let's talk about your investors.
Okay, so
you're not allowed to talk about it, are you? We didn't announce it yet.
We haven't announced it yet. Let's just say this. Let's talk about them without telling about them. That.
Two of my favorite investors in this
world. For all you entrepreneurs out there that you know the journey to raise money, and when people say it's about the right investors, and it's very difficult when you need that money, I cannot tell you how important that is. And
let me add something to that. You are a, as you said before, a content distribution high-end platform.
Yeah.
I can't think of something that has less synergy with Israel than that.
You know something?
It's
very hard. Listen, you know, this is a business that should probably maybe have been based in LA or in New York.
Exactly.
You know, think about how much luxury is there in this country?
We're getting better, but limited. But here's the thing. Without naming names, one of your investors has been on the vlog before, an amazing guy. This is not public information yet, we can't talk about it. But one of the investors, without naming names, had that come to be?
Well, this is a really cool story. So we've been meeting with a lot of investors, going through the traditional journey of meeting with from junior analysts to partners, and we're in a very cool place in Tel Aviv. And at the bottom ground floor of our building, there's an event space. And every so often, the event managers used to like bringing people into our office because it's very lofty and we've got cool digital art all over the walls.
I think the tables.
Sorry, your camera should deal with that. Isn't that stabilizing?
Horrible.
Anyway, can't get the tech anywhere nowadays. Anyway, so all of a sudden it's 10:30 at night, and you know, myself, my co-founder, and one of the other guys, our head of product, we're sitting having dinner as you do as a startup at 10:30 at night in the middle of the week.
Totally.
There's a knock on the door, and in come a group of people, and it was the manager from downstairs in the event space wanting to show someone who was actually being who was involved in an event that evening. They were actually celebrating his philanthropic commitments. Walked into our office because they wanted a break, and we start spending 10-15 minutes talking about the digital art. At the end, I said to him, "So what do you do?" He goes, "I'm an investor." Really? He left the office. 5 minutes later, his partner sent us an email. A week later, they led the round. And it's a story which really could only happen here in Stella.
And I would like to add that you will hear soon, you'll hear more about who this investor is. But this investor is, I think, the most intriguing investor in this country, in that they have probably the best returns than any investor in this country. Incredible portfolio, and you never even heard of them.
And you know what else? They've got amazing digital art on their walls.
There
and
you
if
go.
You want to see digital art on your walls and you want to experience it, check out www.neo.art.
Dude, you are so good, man.
I learned from the best.
You are so good.
I got to run
regards to Shiraz. Have a good one. Let's do dinner soon, man.
All
right?
Yeah.
And
all
cigars.
The best.
Bye. Going, dude. And on that note, I'm going to call it a day and a week. It was a pretty fantastic week. Next week, it's going to be bonkers. See you then.